Hello everyone, I'm back. So I got this. One second, there's a bunch of plastic wrapping everywhere from the Lego sets. Anyways, so I got this, the Lego Nazi set for Christmas. I'm surprised they even sell those, to be honest. Well, it's not officially Lego, I mean. I think it was more of a custom set. But anyway, so yeah, I just decided to quickly put this together. Yeah. I had this from an irrelevant set from a Cosby set that I got last year. Of the Allied Jeep. You know, there's a gunner, this guy. He got shot by this guy. You look closely and I just like barely skimmed him or something. And then this Jeep, or not the Jeep, the transport truck. I know it's a UNSC truck, and the UNSC is heavily based off of US military anyway, so I just thought, you know, it fit in, it's good enough until like, Halo 4. Regardless, got shot by this guy. He has a rocket launcher, an MP40, stick grenade, and a big machete. There's also a Nazi horse. Beautiful Nazi horse. It's this guy, and it's a sniper. I thought he fit the Radiohead description, just because he looks like one of those like German doctors. I don't really know what this like pipe is. I'm not a complete expert. I do know a fair amount of World War II knowledge, but I am not a complete expert. I mean, this guy's just basically like the sniper of the group. Those are like ammo boxes and extra hands that I had. And ammo boxes for these machine guns and stuff. And this guy is an engineer, I guess. He's radio into the commander right there that he set the mine right there. And if I walk over here, you can see that they are flammable gas canisters with one landmine. And I really like this set just because of like the little details. Like, this guy's a flamethrower unit, has an actual like little nozzle. Oh, I'm sorry, Nazi horse. Don't worry. You're helping your cause. You'll probably be shot, but you're doing good, Nazi horse. You're making Hitler proud. Good job. That's a good horse. Realize how unbalanced it actually was. Anyways, so yeah, just little details of like the gas nozzle and stuff. And the commander has like a shotgun. This is also a Nazi dog. This is a dog handler, or just basically the one guy that didn't have his hands full. I tried to use all the weapons, but I mean, I have a few left over. And I don't know, I guess the Steve's, and it can be anything you want, really. I just needed extra things. And it could be, like, civilian clothes, Hitler Youth, soldiers, or if you really want to go that direction, slave Jews. I mean, it's up to interpretation. I was gonna, you know, make an attacked concentration camp, you know, like a liberated one or one that's about to be liberated, but I didn't really have, like, a plane that looks like it belonged in World War II or, like a factory or anything. Well, so I guess it would be a bit controversial. I mean, obviously, with now, with people just saying, everyone I disagree with is a Nazi and stuff like that. But I'm not gonna get too political. It's kind of difficult not to get too political with this set, but I mean, you know. And with the added details that I talked about, this is like the instructions for a lot of them. Yeah, just little details. I never could get the little straps on the Mauser rifles, or Mauser rifles, I don't know how to pronounce it. And what I like about the MP40 in this one is that you can actually detach the magazine. I mean, come on, focus. Okay, there we go. Okay, so how am I going to do this? It does require two hands, but I can figure this out. I guess I could just, like, take one of the guys,